This video will guide you through the installation procedure for the SRAM Eagle 9070 mechanical transmission system. For a full list of tools and supplies, review the user manual at sram.com/service or find it linked in the video description below. SRAM Eagle 9070 mechanical transmission installation is unlike any system before, in which we prepare components off the bike using details of your bike. Loosely hang the components in place, then tighten the components in a specific sequence. Installation is easier than ever, and similar to Eagle Access transmission, but totally new, so please complete the installation and setup in the order shown. Before we prepare any components, consult the full mount chain length guide at sram.com or use the SRAM Access app to determine chain link size, setup key position, and setup cog. To install the Eagle transmission cassette and dub cranks, review the video linked in the upper right corner or consult the user manual at sram.com/service for more information. Install the shifter and loosely install the bolt and the clamp. Adjust the position to rider preference. Tighten the bolts. Consult the SRAM full mount chain length guide available in the SRAM Access app or linked in the description below to determine proper chain length for your bicycle. If your frame is not listed in the full mount chain length guide, review the Eagle transmission user manual linked in the description below for complete instructions. Count down on a new full-length aftermarket T-type chain to the number of chain links determined by the full mount chain length guide available on Access Web or Access app. Use an approved chain breaker tool to break the chain at the inner link. Use a small flathead screwdriver to remove the setup key from the derailleur. Adjust the setup key to the position called out for your bicycle. Install the setup key into the derailleur so the notch is aligned with the corresponding letter, A or B. Failure to position the setup key correctly will result in an inaccurate chain gap, poor shifting performance, and may even damage your derailleur and/or bicycle frame. Consult the SRAM full mount chain length guide at sram.com or use the SRAM Access app to confirm the setup cog output as 21 tooth or 24 tooth. The 21 tooth cog is gear 7 and indicated on the cassette with a red circle. The 24 tooth cog is gear 6, the next larger cog. Use your hands to push the parallelogram inboard until the hexagonal cutout is visible between the fin cutouts. This is the set cog position. Hold the parallelogram in the setup cog position and install the appropriate hex wrench into the hexagonal cutout in the bottom of the parallelogram. Make sure the hex wrench is fully seated. Use a 4mm hex wrench for 21 tooth gear 7 setup cog. Use a 5mm hex wrench for 24 tooth gear 6 setup cog. Make sure the hex tool is keyed and aligned inside the hexagonal cutout with the flat sides of the tool against the flat sides of the cutout. You must use a hex wrench that maintains the shape of the hex head so that it fits into the keyed cutout. Do not use a ball-shaped hex wrench or rubber-coated arm, as it will change the position of the setup cog, resulting in poor shifting performance. Do not rotate the tool while installed in the hexagonal cutout, as this may damage the actuation fin. The universal derailleur hanger, or UDH, must be removed from the frame before derailleur installation. Turn the UDH bolt clockwise to remove it from the hanger threads. Remove the UDH washer along with the UDH bolt. Rotate the UDH hanger backward to unseat the hanger from the pocket. Remove the UDH from the frame. Remove the mount bolt and bushing frame insert from the derailleur. Clean the frame to remove any grease or debris. Install the bushing frame insert from the outside with the black side facing outwards into the hangerless interface. Before proceeding, make sure the cage assembly is fully tightened onto the derailleur body. Rotate the knurled ring so that it is touching the knurled ring stop. Apply grease to the mount bolt threads and underside of the bolt flange. Hang the full mount derailleur with the full mount sliding over the hangerless interface and bushing frame insert. Install and tighten the mount bolt clockwise to snug. Loosen the mount bolt counterclockwise one full turn. Rotate the derailleur cage forward until the lock icon on the cage clears the cage mode button pin. Press the cage mode button to set the derailleur cage to open mode. The pulley cage is spring-loaded and will return from the cage open position rapidly. Keep fingers clear of pinch points. Apply grease to the through axle threads before axle installation. Install the through axle and wheel according to the manufacturer's instructions and tighten to snug. Loosen the through axle bolt counterclockwise one full turn. Stop. Verify the chain has been cut to the proper size and the transmission derailleur is in the setup cog and setup key positions, as determined on Axis Web or Axis App, and set up in the Prepare the Part section. E-bikes must be powered off before proceeding. Place the properly sized Eagle T-type chain on the setup cog, 21 tooth or 24 tooth, and route through the derailleur pulleys with the flat edge of the chain facing away from the cassette. Make sure to route the chain below the tab in the cage. Pull each end of the chain together and install the power lock. Press the power lock connector links together. The arrow on the outer plate must point in the direction of chain travel before locking the power lock into place. Once locked, the power lock cannot be reused if removed. Rotate the derailleur cage forward to release the cage mode button from the fully extended position. Lock the cage mode button at the derailleur cage where the two key lines meet. Press the cage mode button to set the derailleur cage to setup mode. The derailleur is spring-loaded and will return rapidly. Keep fingers clear of pinch points. Check that the two halves of the power lock are properly aligned. Use chain link pliers to lock the power lock. Alternatively, rotate the crank until the power lock is above the chainstay and confirm the two halves are still connected. Apply the rear brake and firmly push the crank arm down to lock the power lock. You should hear and feel the power lock click into place. Check the power lock by hand to make sure it moves freely. The power lock is designed for one-time use only. The power lock can only be removed with chain link pliers and must not be reused. Install a new power lock each time a new chain is installed. Reusing a power lock may result in a broken chain that could result in a crash. Before proceeding, verify the completion of all steps in the prepare and hang the component sections. The chain is properly engaged on the setup cog and chain ring. The cage is locked in the setup position. The power lock is closed and the bicycle suspension is uncompressed at 0% sag unless otherwise instructed. Pull back on the lower cage of the derailleur to remove slack from the chain. Continue to pull back while you rotate the crank forwards two rotations and confirm the chain stays on the setup cog. Tighten the mount bolt while continuing to pull back on the lower cage of the derailleur. Then release. If there is still slack in the chain after tightening the mount bolt, loosen the bolt and repeat the previous steps. Verify the knurled ring mark is aligned with the mark on the full mount of the derailleur. If it is not aligned, loosen the mount bolt. Rotate the knurled ring so that it is touching the knurled ring stop and repeat the previous steps. Tighten the rear axle to torque according to the frame or axle manufacturer's instructions. Release the cage from the setup mode by rotating the cage forward, then carefully letting it return to the unlocked position. Push the parallelogram inward to release the hex wrench from the parallelogram hexagonal cutout. Rotate the crank forward to move the chain fully outboard to gear 12. Rotate the barrel adjuster on the shifter clockwise until it stops. Measure and cut a length of compressionless shifter housing so that there are no tight bends or long loops when installed into the frame. You must use 1.1 mm stainless steel shift cable and 4 mm compressionless shift cable housing in the mechanical Eagle transmission system. Hold the shifter housing up to the shifter lever with a length of housing that creates a gentle bend in the housing and allows the handlebars to freely turn about 120 degrees, or as allowed by any rotation limiting devices. Large or long loops will introduce more overall angle change than a small or short bend, resulting in additional friction and reduced shifting performance. Cut the housing of the shifter. Cut the housing at the derailleur to allow a small, smooth bend with a direct path into the derailleur to minimize the angle change. Install a metal ferrule onto the housing at the shifter and the derailleur. Install the housing into the rear derailleur. Make sure the ferrules are fully seated onto the housing and into the components. Loose ferrules may affect system performance. Rotate the derailleur cage forward until the lock icon on the cage clears the setup key. Press the cage mode button to lock the transmission cage in open mode. The derailleur is spring-loaded and will return from the cage lock position rapidly. Keep your fingers clear of pinch points. Route the cable through the housing, roll-a-ma-jig, and through the actuation fin. Make sure to go through the tab on the actuation fin. Route the cable under the clamp groove and anchor bolt. Pull the cable taut in the direction of the groove. Press the release lever on the shifter to release all tension. The shifter must be in gear 12. Rotate the derailleur cage forward to release the cage mode button from the fully extended position. Make sure the metal ferrules are fully seated at the barrel adjuster in the shifter and in the derailleur. Pull the cable taut. Keep the cable taut, but do not push the parallelogram inboard and tighten the anchor bolt. Rotate the crank forward while you turn the barrel adjuster counterclockwise to add tension to the cable until the chain rotates on the 10-tooth cog, gear 12, with minimal noise. Adjust as necessary. Press the shifter paddle to shift inboard one cog to the 12-tooth cog, gear 11. Continue to rotate the cranks and adjust the barrel adjuster until the chain rotates on the 12-tooth cog, gear 11, with minimal noise. Shift outboard to the 10-tooth cog, gear 12. Repeat the previous steps to confirm a crisp shift. If it takes more than 7 full counterclockwise barrel adjuster rotations to tune the system, repeat the cable routing section and ensure the ferrules are fully seated and all slack is out of the cable when tightening the anchor bolt. Cut the excess cable so about 30 millimeters of cable remains past the cable anchor bolt. Install an end cap onto the cable. Crimp the end cap. Tuck the excess cable behind the actuation fin. Rotate the crank slowly and shift the derailleur all the way inboard. Continue to rotate the cranks and shift the derailleur all the way outboard. Make small barrel adjustments as needed to provide smooth shifting up and down the cassette. The pulleys may appear to be unaligned. They are intentionally offset to improve chain travel and direction to the chainring. This completes the system installation. There are no adjustment screws in this system. You must repeat the complete installation procedure if you change any of the following on your bicycle: chainring size, geometry adjustment to chainstay length, or position of a lower idler pulley. Failure to repeat the complete installation process when changing chainring size, bike geometry, or after replacing the chain may result in damage to your system or poor drivetrain performance. SRAM Eagle Mechanical Transmission is designed to shift best when in sag and pedaled. Some barrel adjustments may be needed on the first few rides. Make small barrel adjustments as needed.